God knoweth those who are his. Let everyone that liveth after the name of Christ be departed away from iniquity. For in a big house like Bethany Jowulu Methodist Church, there are not only vessels of gold and clay, and some of wood, some of silver, some to dishonor and some to honor. But if you and I will pledge ourselves as a vessel of honor, God will use us as a vessel of honor. In the anointing in this case of the woman has no problem with the oil, but he has problem with the vessels. In the same way, God has no problem with the oil. Some of you are looking for the oil of preaching. You are looking for the apostolic oil. You are looking for the prophetic oil. Some of you are desiring my grace. You are desiring an anointing. It is not a problem for God to give you. But the question is, are you a vessel? Are you a vessel for God to put that thing in you? I pray for you tonight. You will purge yourself and come alive. You will become a vessel of honor. You will become a vessel of good. To mix the good and the happy work of the Father. I came to tell you, if you can purge yourself, God will use you. God is looking for vessels. He says, for the laborers are too few, but the work is too much. God is looking for laborers. And I invite you into the vineyard of God. Take a hand in hand with me. We shall work in this kingdom of God. And we shall let the power of Christ. If I'm preaching to you, come on, clap your hands like you are sitting in front of a preacher. Hey! I'm about to preach. I'm about to preach. Can I preach? Abba! In me. If you are bad, someone tell me one. It's conditional. If you abide in me, catch this revelation. Watch this one. Somebody say if. In your flow. Somebody say if. Can I explain the if? Yes. See that. If you abide in me, I'm about to do it. If you abide in me, if you can still come to church despite your problems, if you can still lift up your voice and worship in spite of your weeping at night, if you abide in me, if you can still be punctual with the duties of God despite your difficulties, if you are still unemployed, and can still come to the house of the Lord, give what is due to God, and can still sit in God's house, and still lift up your voice and praise Him in spite of your problems and your shambles. If you can still come to church after losing that job, if you can still come to church and sound like a correct Christian in church, that you don't come to church and carry your problems on your face, if you in me. If you can be like Job for one time, if you can be like Job, a man who went to bed loaded, but he woke up empty. Before Job went to bed, he was the billionaire in all the east. But when he woke up, everything of him got lost. Job was standing in front of 10 coffins. My father, I don't know, something is coming upon me. Job was standing in front of 10 coffins. He had 10 children. Thank you. If you take a mountain, as at the phone could jump out, whoa,
whoa,
he money way, again, he money way, he money way, Sasa Trome,
yet righteous in him. It doesn't look at your testimony. Because I'm not preaching about fruits, I'm preaching about wine. So Christians, you only shout for fruits, you don't shout for your connection with the wine.
Yeah! He's hearing me!
He chooses not to bless me, I'll still come to church. That is my belief now. Even if he chooses not to bless me, I'll still love him. If he abide in me, if he abide in me, if he abide in me.
Galatians chapter 6, verse 7. Let's look something there. Galatians chapter 6, verse 7.
Paul and I, Casa. Paul. Galatians chapter 6. Verse 17. 17. Look at Paul, Apostle Paul. Apostle Paul said,
from henceforth,
let no man trouble me, for I bear in my body the mass of the Lord Jesus. Give a clap of Lord Jesus.
Let no man trouble me.
He said, I have kept the faith. Many a time.